it. Very great that you actually stopped by my room. I actually have this art project that's coming up, that's due, and like I have to get a whole bunch of references and stuff, and I have to sketch out like all these characters and start the character design process. Since you're here, I was wondering if maybe you could help out with that. Really? Cool. Yeah, I'm just gonna be like sketching out a couple different positions. If you're not familiar with the character design process, I need first I need just a general shape of the character, which you obviously look perfect for said character. But oh yeah, it's definitely the hero of the story, the protagonist, if you will. But I'm gonna need a couple different angles. If you're willing and have the time, I would love you to hang out. Cool. Okay. Well, I'm just gonna set this down for a minute. Okay. Just hold still. I'm gonna get kind of close and kind of just arrange some stuff here. Perfect, you look fantastic. Alright. So like I said, I'm just gonna be doing a couple of different just basic sketches. Doesn't matter how many times you start something like this, like it never gets any easier. Especially when your pencil is being weird. Perfect. Okay, so I'm just gonna do just a face right on with me there. Usually start off with like drawing the overall circle of the head. So like you've got your skull, and then you've got your jaw that comes on down, and that's usually what I draw next. It's just like a line right down the middle for this first position. The different positions when you're designing characters. So you've got the front. There's usually four main ones per se, you know. You've got the front one that's, you know, facing straight onto the camera. Then you've got the three quarter. Okay, so it's like facing a little bit. And then you've got the sideways profile, so you just can see just like, you know, the whole side of the face and body, and then you've got the turned around, and then some animators, like if it's more of a production, and more of like action sequences, then they will of go into more, I don't know, poses. I guess you could say more dynamic poses, just so you can get the general idea. And of course, the like Disney, for example, they'll do a lot of facial expressions in their concept art. Thanks again for helping me out with this, by the way. It's always super awkward just like asking people to help out with this kind of thing. So by now I've got your basic facial features. I'm just gonna rearrange your hair just a little bit more. Okay. All right, perfect. My favorite part is always drawing the hair, because I mean that's some of the most freeing. Strokes, or I'm so used to doing digital art, pen lines, freeing lines, because hair is just, it kind of does its own thing, you know what I'm saying? Like it's just there, it kind of lives on its own, you know? Turned out. Okay, so now with the like 3/4, I'm gonna need you to turn just a little bit, just your head just a little bit this way. Perfect. Okay. No, this definitely helps a lot. This way when because this is for an animation class, so I mean whenever they're animating, they need to know what every part of the character looks like, so it helps. You're doing great, by the way. Okay. Also, is this not the coolest sketchbook you've ever seen? I guess he's quite a large bee, but still nice all of the same. Time to get the like proportions of like face and facial structure and like noticing that in real people. It's such a pain. It's like one of those things you like almost can never get used to. this quick sketch of those two positions, and now I'm going to do a little bit of shading, so just hang with me just a little bit longer. So we're almost done. Shading to me is one of the hardest parts, so like when I do it, I've got to really concentrate, which is why it's like one of those things where you can't really talk while you're doing it. One thing that I read at one point was like when you're doing something to your fullest extent, like multitasking doesn't exist. When you're doing something to your fullest capacity, then everything else just kind of shuts off, which I thought was extremely cool. So something like shading for me, it's almost like I can't do anything else when I am in the middle of shading, I guess you could say. Art is kind of the same way for me. If I'm just like enhancing the line art a little bit, which is what I'm about to do, because I'm still just doing the rough shading, rough sketches and stuff. I'm gonna get a pen in a moment to finish out the line art. Thing about my style is I really, really like hatching. So it's basically, I'll use this as an example. So I'm trying to shade, like, can't really see that line. And so you just kind of do this number right there in order to shade it. Like, the more lines you put on there, the more shaded the area is. So keep that in mind next time you do some drawing. Okay. Now I'm gonna find my pen. Okay, so I found my pen. I'm going to go in and increase the value of the line art lines. This pen is really good because it's such a narrow tip point and it's just so smooth, so like it just really glides right across the paper. It also kind of sounds nice when you are drawing with it, so these characters are turning out really good. Fantasy action animation film. Basically, the character that you were modeling for is going to have to go on this adventure. Okay, and when they go on this adventure, they encounter a variety of things, mainly animals. That they're not what you would typically think a like scary animal would be, but they are scary in this world, because that's kind of the whole premise of the show, is that the animals that are like small and harmless, say a squirrel, is be more dangerous in this situation. So your character is going to be fighting off lots of things such as squirrels and things of that nature. Chipmunks, you know how it is. Small rodents. It's a good time. It really is. I can't wait to show you the character design for the for the chicken that is the kind of like the final boss in the end. Yeah, I know, it's pretty hilarious. And hoping that the whole thing will get that kind of reaction out of everybody. Finish. Get some more of your hair in there. Smooth this over here just a little bit. Okay, perfect. Okay. You're able to take the time to model for me and help me out with this. So the final product here, here it is right here. This is what you look like. Very good. I know you're very pleased with the results, but yes, so I've got to get going. I've got class coming up, so I'd rather not miss that. But thanks again for being here. Hope you can